What's up guys, this is Hal Hart back with another video. Before we get started, make sure you subscribe and hit that bell icon for my new video post. In this video, we will be talking about projection, and specifically projection with raster data images. So I'm going to be going over three main topics in this one. And if you go to raster and you go to projections, these are the three projection functions I will be talking about. Let's start with the first one, which is assign projection. And it is basically exactly what it says. To assign a projection, you're going to select your input layer that either has or does not have a projection. And you're going to choose a projection by clicking these either the drop down or this button right here, and it'll bring up all the projections that you have on your computer or that you can connect to. Alright, so that one's quick and easy. It's just assigning. The next one is extracting a projection. Right, so you basically put in your file and you say, okay, I like this CRS and I want to extract this CRS from this this file. And you can also create a whole separate file that is a projection. And then we have our last one, which is a little bit longer to explain. Alright, so with warp reproject, you can choose different resampling methods. You can choose the CRS. So the first thing that we look at here, it has an input layer, and I'll just input a random layer. And you can use this source. What is the source CRS for this input layer? So let's say if you assigned a CRS for this layer, but it was on a separate file or a separate projection file, you could use that file as an optional CRS projection. Now the target CRS is what reference system that you want to change this entire layer to. Alright, the next thing is the resampling method, and there are several different options. I don't want to go through all of them. You can play with them if you want to, but we're going to keep moving. The no data value, right? So you can set what this means. What do you want to see that means no data? So right now it's just not set, but I can set it for negative 99.99 or whatever. You can set it for 23, whatever you want. It's optional. All right, next thing is the output file resolution. You can also play with the resolution. I mean, you can just set it wherever you really want to, but I'll leave mine not set. And all these options with projections are great when you say you get map data that has a CRS that you don't like, or you specifically need to use a different CRS. You can reproject your images and your data. All right. If you have any comments or questions, leave them in the comments section. We're welcoming in a new year, 2019, but don't forget to like and subscribe. And as always, I will see you in the next one. Peace.